Hey everyone, my name is Sahil, and in this video, we will do a brief overview of the international standards used in the design and installation of lightning protection systems. I will discuss two international standards. First of all, the IEC 62305, which is the lightning protection system design standard, and IEC 62561, which is the system components standard. At Axis, our lightning protection engineers use IEC 62305 for designing lightning protection systems, including placement of all the components. Also, manufacturers like us use IEC 62561 for the testing, the compliance, and the quality checking of all of our components. So let's start with IEC 62305. It is the apex level document that informs the standards for lightning protection across the world. It comprises of four parts that provide lightning protection designers with the rules and regulations required to design a system. Part 1 is a general introduction to the threat of lightning. Part 2 delves into the calculation of lightning risk. Part 3 describes the design of lightning protection system, or LPS. And Part 4 describes the design of the surge protection measures, or SPM. Please note that this standard does not consider the following cases under its scope: railway systems, ships, aircraft, or offshore installations, underground high pressure pipelines, and power and telecommunication lines placed outside of a structure. Let's start with part 1. IEC 62305 part 1 is a general introduction to the entire standard. In addition to the properties and factors used to simulate the effects of lightning strikes, the basics of procedures and principles that are used in the rest of the standard are also explained in IEC 62305 part 1. Okay, so what about part 2? It's called risk management. Part 2 is the key to correctly implementing part 3 and part 4 of the standard. It is concerned with the lightning risk assessment of a structure and to determine whether it requires a lightning protection system or not. This part provides the complete framework for risk assessment on four primary types of losses: the loss of human life or permanent injuries, the loss of service to the public, the loss of cultural heritage, and economic losses. Protection measures in part 3 and 4 are determined based on the risk assessment and the residual risk. This residual risk is reduced using protection measures until it is below a certain defined tolerable risk. Using part 2, we also determine the class of lightning protection system to be used for the structure. Now moving on to part 3. Physical damage to structures and life hazards. This part deals with the protection of people and structures from damage like touch and step voltages. You can read more about touch and step voltage in our blog. The link will be in the description. Part 3 states that the main and most effective measure of protection of structures from physical damage is considered to be the lightning protection system, which is further divided into two types: external system and internal systems. The external lightning protection system comprises of an air termination system, a down conductor system, and an earth termination system. The internal lightning protection system includes equipotential bonding and surge protection. Hence, IEC 62305 Part 3 provides the guidelines to help designers, installers, architects, and builders to correctly design, install, and maintain the external and internal lightning protection system to protect people from direct lightning strikes and touch and step voltages. Finally, IEC 62305 Part 4, Electrical and Electronic Systems Within Structures. This part was introduced due to the ever-increasing cost of failures of electrical and electronic systems. It provides details for the design, installation, inspection, maintenance, and testing of surge protection measures to protect systems from the effects of lightning electromagnetic impulses. Part 4 also introduces lightning protection zones. Here, the central idea is to limit current and voltage surges by dividing the structure into different risk zones. These zones are implanted within each other, with the most sensitive zones being the innermost. Hence, an assessment is performed for each zone to select the most appropriate protection at the optimum cost. By using standard appropriate solutions like lightning arrestors, surge protection devices, the effects of lightning hitting the outer zone are meant to be reduced before they can affect people or sensitive equipment in the inner zones. Axis can help you design the entire process from step one of risk assessment to the last step of the actual design, including our internationally approved products. Our engineers will be on the field with you to make sure that they provide the most precise protection for your system. Now coming to IEC 62561, Components of Lightning Protection System. This series of standards summarizes the requirements and tests for various components of the lightning protection system, including connection components such as lightning conductor clamps, bonding and earthing clamps, bridging components, pipe clamps, and equipotential bonding bars, conductors and earth electrodes, conductor fasteners, earth pits, lightning strike counters, earth enhancing compounds. IEC 62561 defines specific testing and quality measures for each one of these products, and this level of detail is out of the scope of this video, but we encourage you to go read IEC 62561 to understand what the testing requirements will be for any product that you're looking to purchase. You now have a brief understanding of IEC 62561 and the four parts of IEC 62305. However, for avoiding electrical hazards, you should only procure products certified according to international or national standards for your lightning protection requirements. At Axis, we design lightning protection systems and have been manufacturing the entire range of lightning protection components for over 25 years, with supplies to hundreds of projects across more than 80 countries. Please share your feedback and queries in the comment section below if you have any questions about any of these standards. Do like and subscribe to our channel for more videos about lightning protection and grounding system, along with other videos about electrical engineering. I'll see you in the next video.